What's your hurry, Angie?
I thought you promised Marshal Earp not to make any more trouble.
No trouble. I just want to have a sociable talk. Come on in here, huh?
Stop that!
Oh, what are you doing? Being hard to get?
You let go of me! I have a gun!
You give me that. Why, you little wasp!
Hold it! You go on down and join your husband. Go on.
She shot me.
I'll take care of you. Go on.
Get inside.
Life and Legend of Wyatt Earp, starring Hugh O'Brien. Marriages between white men and Indian girls happened rarely, even on the Kansas frontier of 1877. Despite the sentimental guff written about squaw men, the strongest barrier to such marriages was the sacrifice demanded of any Indian girl who dared to marry a white man. Fighting tribes like the Sioux, the Apaches, and the Cheyenne greeted such romances with deadly anger. Marshal Earp would rather face a great gunman than become involved with a white husband and an Indian wife.
I'll be a squaw man in a Dodge Hotel.
You're going upstairs.
That's something. Ain't a bad looking filly either.
I left my gun out in the wagon. I'll meet you outside.
I'll be with you in just a second, Mr. Squaw Man.
What's it all about, mister?
Never mind. Let's get out of range.
You're a slow hand, Mr. Jones. This young fella's sore and he's sober.
He insulted me and my wife. Oh, you're the marshal.
Look, Mr. Jones is a slow hand with a gun. He's been drinking. You want an apology or an easy gunfight?
An apology.
Look, I'm trying to save your life. Either you apologize or I stand aside and let you shoot it out.
So I apologize. Look, my wife and boy are in
when
there.
When I stop a gunfight, I aim to keep it stopped.
I'm sorry. Are you Wyatt Earp?
That's right.
Well, then, from what I've heard about you, I'll have a chance to explain the trouble.
All right. We'll take a walk and cool off.
Dick?
Well, first, I'd like you to meet my wife, Mrs. Melanie. Laura, this is Marshal Wyatt Earp.
Howdy, man. Your husband was going to kill Mr. Jones, and I didn't think he should.
Well, no, thank you. I left the baby inside. I better go back.
I'll be right along, honey.
I remember now. Your wife is the daughter of Two Moon, chief of the Cheyenne. You folks got a cattle spread up north on the Wyoming line.
Well, now, how did you know that?
Well, I got a couple of Cheyenne friends, Mr. Brother and Mr. Cousin. They gossip. Come on, we'll take that walk.
Without Laura, I'd still be a busted cowhand working cattle somewhere in Texas.
Well, sit down, sir.
She stood by me through 2 blizzards, a drought, and nursed me through a fever. I owe her more than any man should owe a woman.
Well, any husband with a good wife feels the same way.
Well, this isn't the same kind of love, Marshal. She broke with her people for me. I urge this trip because I want to prove to her that she's my wife no matter what part of the country we're in. And for all time. You think I'm wrong?
No, Mr. Melanie, I just think you got a special kind of a problem, but that doesn't mean you got to go around fighting with every stupid sidewinder that makes remarks. You know, I've heard Indians make remarks, too. You couldn't print what some of them say.
Well, my father-in-law doesn't think too much of me.
Old Two Moon? Yeah, he's a He's a real tough customer. Well, you'll be all right once you get east to Kansas City. Out here, a lot of blood has been spilled on both sides. I happen to think the Indians got a pretty rotten deal, but, well, the Indians aren't angels either.
Well, Laura admits that. Unless she remembers how our people are outnumbered.
Mr. Melanie, I'm ashamed to say this, but I advise you to stick close to the hotel. Your train leaves in the morning.
I know. Well, we won't give you cause for any more trouble. And thank you, Marshal.
Yeah. Let's get back to the hotel.
Oh. Who is it?
It's your husband, Laura.
Oh.
Well, that's better. Why the locked door, huh?
That man is still in the hotel.
Oh, just a stupid drunk. Hello, son. There's nothing sissy about this kid. Takes after your father.
Some, but more you. What did Mr. Earp have to say?
Oh, nothing much. He thinks we ought to keep off the streets. Just to avoid another hoodlum like Jones.
So we must hide from white people.
Only in Dodge City, honey.
It's that Custer fight. My father told me the Sioux were trying to run away and Custer charged them with his pony soldiers. So you and I have to hide.
All right. I have to go to the depot and buy tickets. You and Grant come with me. We won't hide.
Hide?
What else?
No. I am bad-tempered. You go to the station, but you leave your gun here. Mr. Earp is a good man, and we will do as he says. Now go quickly, and I'll prepare food for us.
Now that's my girl. Well, you can heat Little Chief's milk in the hotel kitchen. And don't forget to boil it, huh?
I am stupid, dirty Indian.
Oh, no, we smoked the peace pipe, remember?
Yes, I remember, my sweetheart.
I'll be back.
Now, you be a good boy, and I'll be right back. I'll bring you some milk.
Well, hello now. There's nothing to be scared of. I like engines.
Please, I'm going to the kitchen.
Well, no hurry. Come on, let's have a drink.
No, no, stop. Let go of me. I have a gun.
Oh, sure. You're a bad little engine. You little...
Oh. I'll shoot you in the head this time.
No. Now, you go on back in your room and stay there. Where's your husband?
He went to the depot to buy tickets.
I'll talk to him about this. Now, you go on back in your room.
I'll get you to the doctor. Caused enough trouble around here.
She shot me.
I don't care.
Let me explain it. She'll think you're going to put her in jail.
Look, she shot him in self-defense. I can explain that.
I knew it.
Grant and I go back to our people. We love you, but we are Cheyenne. Laura.
I can catch him if you give me a fast horse.
Just take it easy. Sit down. You know your wife better than to try forcing her to come back. You got any idea where Two Moon is? North or west, and a dozen trails to follow.
I should never have left him alone. Two Moon will keep them. I know him.
Maybe. But
Let's see what Mr. Cousin and Mr. Brother had to say about this. Now, you stay here.
Girl who talk white go to mission school. Tumu not like it. Then she marry Mr. Maloney. Tumu not like it. Then she have son, named boy after President Grant. Tumu not like that either. He like Horace Greeley.
All right, Mr. Cousin. Where's Mrs. Maloney now?
Whiter, bate ete, Tumu chatso.
Mr. Abe Chukma, imi noble, he.
Girl who talk white and little boy go to Tumu's camp. She's afraid she get put in jail for shooting bad white men.
How did you know about that?
You sent for us. We asked Tumun if it's all right. He not like it.
Well, Tumun never likes anything. Now, which way to his camp?
Pony soldier after Tumun. We tell, he kill us.
Is his camp far away? All right. You asked Tumun to meet me on the trail. Half a day ride from this camp.
What if he say no, Mr. Herb?
Well, then I'll take a posse and find Tumun. There'll be a lot of bang-bang.
Bacaldo ijeaje bang-bang, Tumun.
Push no, emino, keo, Tumun.
Mr. Brother wants to know if you promise not to kill Tumun.
I won't kill Tumun, but you can tell him this for me. If he doesn't talk this over peaceably, he isn't going to live too long. We have to raid that camp. Their bullets are going to be flying awful thick.
Ate tejo. You camp here, my good friend. We tell to move. Tejo.
Your grandson is a smart little fella.
Why you say little white talk is smart?
Well, his father gave him some toy soldiers and Indians, and he pulled the arms and legs off half of the soldiers so it'd be easier for the Indians to scalp him. Now, why don't you send your daughter back to her husband?
White husband is a coward.
Oh?
Cowhand insulted my daughter. Is Cowhand dead?
Your daughter wounded him.
Brave husband fight for wife. Let white husband kill Cowhand. Bring his body to me. Then I will talk with him.
Well, I can't make any promises for Mr. Maloney. Now tell him what you said.
A good beefsteak.
Yes, sir. Would you like to have a little bit?
Thank you.
Nice family you married into. Your father-in-law wants you to kill Rex Jones and bring the body into camp.
Well, I can't do that.
Yeah, I know.
Jones hit the trail for Texas this morning. Oh, I wouldn't have tried to gun him down. I'm not Cheyenne, and I don't take orders from Tumun.
Well, I'll get a hold of Sheriff Masterson. We'll round up some deputies and raid the camp.
No deal.
Look, I can do it legally. Grant your little boy and Tumun kidnapped him.
Tumun wouldn't harm him and lawyer. But the young braves might. Just loan me a Cheyenne, friends. Laura must be pretty well sick of life in a Cheyenne lodge by now. I think I can talk her into leaving with me.
Sure, and get yourself killed, too. You know, you're not very popular with that old Indian.
Tumun thought he owned Laura. Wish me luck, huh?
Well, I'm going along, too. Meet me over at the jail, huh? You know, Mr. Brother and Mr. Cousin aren't like horses and guns. You can't borrow them. Now, I can find Tumun, but it's going to take a little longer.
Quiet.
What's the matter, Al?
Well,
go on.
We had to shoot three-fingered Finnegan.
What?
He cut loose on Jocko, winged him in the gun arm.
Finnegan dead?
Yes, sir.
Come here.
was the body?
At the coroner's.
All right. I want you to snatch that body tonight and follow my trail in the morning.
But why?
That's an order. I'll take the blame. Go on. Well?
You have risked your life for us many times. We do what you say.
He.
Good. Bring that saddlebag with.
My father's having us watched. You must go quick.
We rode all night to get here, Laura. Now, Wyatt, brother and cousin are back there close by. We can all leave together. Now, come on.
No, they will kill you. The boy and I are happy here. Please, goodbye.
You're not a very good liar, huh? Now, come on.
Carlo?
Ishkaya.
Ensuele, over another.
We shoot. No, we get out of here.
He comes, sir.
Ciao, El.
What are they saying?
Young man want to shoot Mr. Melanie. Girl who talks white says she must talk to Two Moon first.
We saw. Ne walani, nota.
Hey, amo elego.
Girl having her way. I hope Marshal Earp goes back to Dodge City.
Hey, you two skedaddle out of here. You've done all you can, and I thank you very much.
You stay here?
No.
Where, then?
None of your business. Now, go on. The two of you right out of here, promise.
Mr. Earp, are you Two Moon, eh?
Mr. Brother thinks you go to Two Moon's camp. Is that true?
Eh?
Two Moon will listen to me.
Why?
Mr. Cousin, like you said, this is a family row. Two Moon is a father-in-law. Father-in-laws like to talk a lot. He'll want to tell his side of the story before he does anything to Mr. Melanie.
We stay here and claim body of Marshal Earp.
Si.
Am I invited to wedding? No. Am I told that little white talk is coming? No. Am I asked to see my own grandchild? No. What is Two Moon? Low dog? Coward in battle? I am chief of the Cheyenne. Mr. Melanie was wrong. Wrong? He is a disgrace to me and my people. What is Melanie? A soldier? No. A brave man with a star like you? No, he is nothing. He has a few cattle, land he stole from the Arapaho. My daughter married a thief as well as a coward. No more talk. He dies.
If you let me talk to Mr. Melanie, it may stop a war.
There'll be no war.
Oh, yes. If you kill him and me, the army will be after you.
I do not touch Marshal Earp.
You young braves will get excited and finish me off. It's too bad. Soldiers and Indians dying over a family quarrel. I thought Two Moon was a smart chief.
Wait. What do you say to Melanie?
I tell him he was a complete fool.
What else?
That I would have to take your side.
You stand up for Indian?
You love your grandson. He should be allowed to visit you. And you should always be welcome in Mr. Melanie's home.
I do not like the name Grant. What about the name?
Well, I think he should be christened Grant Two Moon Melanie.
Hmm.
And you should be invited to the christening.
Your heart is good. You talk with this man.
And I'm bound to say that I sympathize with Two Moon. After all, he is your son's grandfather, you know.
It wasn't all my doing.
Laura?
You know how Cheyenne treat their women. Laura came back from mission school. She found her father had stopped trying to act civilized. She was the chief's daughter, but She was his property.
Well, I think the boy has changed to Moon. His first grandson.
Move closer. Laura gave me her gun inside my shirt.
Well, I'll take it. But first, I want to talk to Two Moon again. Tell him that you're sorry, that he'll be treated like a grandfather.
He wants more. You'll see. Now, quick, light me a smoke and take the gun.
I talked to your chief.
Hey, homie.
Where's Wyatt?
He talked to Two Moon.
I stole the body he wanted. Now, what's the plan?
He no tell. I think we wait here.
And I better not go barging in any Cheyenne camp until Wyatt says so.
I give you my word. Mr. Melanie's heart has changed. You will belong to his family after this. But it isn't going to help any. You're keeping him and Laura and little Grant Two Moon prisoner.
You forget something.
What?
Cohan insult my daughter. Where is body?
You'll get the body.
When?
Look, I've taken your side. Mr. Melanie has promised to act decent. And all you can think about is cruel Indian revenge.
Apamo! Aya Taco!
No. Now you walk out of here with your hands up. Go on.
Pechi Tanopa.
Now I'm taking the Melanies out of this camp. Any objections from you and you'll be shot. I'll tell your men to get in front of you and walk.
Opanichi. Opanichi!
Go on. Hold it. Now bring out your daughter and her son.
Hey! No shooting, Hal, no! Hal, no shooting!
Did you bring the man that Dick killed?
He's back there in the wagon.
Bring him here. I will look at him. Get Melanie and my grandson. Look with care, my daughter. Is that the man?
Yes. He is the man who insulted me.
Then you are not a coward. Take your wife and go.
Not without my son.
Now tell your grandfather you will see him soon.
You will all leave. Except Marshal Earp. All go. Give it to him. My daughter is still mine. She grabbed gun for fear you shoot. My grandson is mine. He hold my hand real tight. True. I will try to like my son-in-law. But that is not body of man who insult my family. This is Three Fingers Finnegan. Your own men shoot him in Dodge City. I will say this for Marshal Earp. He keep face like Indian. Chakma Hattak.
Chakma Hattak.
You think little Two Moon look like me?
Yes, sir. I think there's a strong resemblance.
Good. You go now.
Thank you, Chief.
Well, he cleaned up the country, the old Wild West country. He made law and order prevail. and none can deny it. The legend of Wyatt forever will live on the trail.
Oh, Wyatt Earp, Wyatt Earp, brave, courageous, and bold. Long live his fame.